The Capture of Patrick. When Patrick was a young boy, he lived in Wales. His father was an official of the Roman Empire, which at that time ruled a large part of the known world. Now, in those days, there were many Irish raiders who sailed across the Irish Sea to the British mainland, where they robbed, fought, and stole anything of value to bring back to Ireland. They kidnapped many people and brought them back to be sold as slaves all over Ireland. Patrick was 15 when he was kidnapped, brought back to Ireland, and sold as a slave to a man called Milcu in County Antrim. Milcu lived close to where the present town of Ballymena stands, and he made Patrick look after his sheep and cattle on a mountain called Slemish on the banks of the River Braid. It was a harsh and lonely life because Patrick had to live, work and even sleep on the mountain through all the seasons of the year. He missed his family very much, and on many a long, cold winter's night, with only the animals for company, he felt very sad and often went hungry as well. But through all this terrible hardship, Patrick prayed many times every day and found great comfort in speaking to God. Patrick spent 5 long years on the mountain of Slemish, and that must have seemed like an eternity to the young boy. He often thought that he would remain there forever in his loneliness, poverty, and suffering. Then one day, as he tended the animals on the slopes of Slemish Mountain, an angel appeared to Patrick and told him that there was a ship waiting for him in which he could make his escape. Patrick wrapped his cloak around him against the night chill and made his way to where the angel said the ship was waiting. Once he was on board, the ship weighed anchor, and in the silence of the night, Patrick stole away from Slemish, from Ireland, and made his way to freedom. When he eventually reached his family home in Wales, there were great celebrations and tears of joy from his family, who noticed how tall and grown up Patrick had become in his 5 years of slavery in Ireland. However, in spite of all his hardship and loneliness in the County Antrim, Patrick felt in his heart that he would live to see Ireland